was out.
The testing area is just up ahead. The quicker you get through, the quicker you'll get your $60. Caroline, are the compensation vouchers ready?
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson.
Why did I just... Who is that? What the hell is going on here?
War hero and or Olympian, with your help, we're gonna
change the world.
This on? Hey, listen up down there. That thing's called an elevator, not a bathroom.
I swear I know him.
If you're interested in an additional $60, flag down a test associate and let them know. You could walk out of here with 120 weighing down your bindle if you let us take you apart, put some science stuff in you, and then put you back together. Good as new. If you're interested, there's still some positions available for that bonus opportunity I mentioned earlier. Again, all you gotta do is let us disassemble you. We're not banging rocks together here. We know how to put a man back together. So, that's a complete reassembly. New vitals, spit shine on the old ones, plus we're scooping out tumors. Frankly, you ought to be paying us. you. I can't believe I'm thanking these people. For staggering your way through Aperture Science's propulsion gel testing, you've made some real contributions to society for a change, and for that, humanity is grateful. If you had any belongings, please pick them up now. We don't want to lose papers and sticks cluttering up the building. For many of you, I realize $60 is an unprecedented windfall, so don't go spending it all on, I don't know, Carolyn, what do these people buy?
Carolyn, why do I know this woman? Did I kill her? Or... Oh my God. Look, you're doing a great job. Can you handle things for yourself for a while? I need to think.
Welcome to the Enrichment Center. Since making test participation mandatory for all employees, the quality of our test subjects has risen dramatically. Employee retention, however, has not. As a result, you may have heard we're going to phase out human testing. There's still a few things left to wrap up, though. The bean counters told me we literally could not afford to buy $7 worth of moon rocks, much less 70 million. Bought them anyway. Ground them up, mixed them into a gel. Guess what? Ground up moon rocks are pure poison. I am deadly ill. Still, it turns out they're a great portal conductor. So now, we're going to see if jumping in and out of these new portals can somehow leach the lunar poison out of a man's bloodstream. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Let's all stay positive and do some science. That said, I would really appreciate it if you could test as fast as possible. Carolyn, please bring me more pain pills. Life gives you lemons. Don't make lemonade.
Yeah.
Make life take the lemons back.
Yeah.
Get mad!
Yeah.
I don't want your damn lemons! What am I supposed to do with these?
Yeah, take the lemons.
Demand to see life's manager.
Yeah.
Make life rue the day it thought it could give Cave Johnson lemons. Do you know who I am? I'm the man who's gonna burn your house down with the lemons.
Oh, I like this guy.
I'm gonna get my engineers to invent a combustible lemon that burns your house down. The point is, if we can store music on a compact disc, why can't we store a man's intelligence and personality on one? So I have the engineers figuring that out now. Brain mapping. Artificial intelligence. We should have been working on it 30 years ago. I will say this, and I'm gonna say it on tape so everybody hears it 100 times a day. If I die before you people can pour me into a computer, I want Carolyn to run this place. Now, she'll argue. She'll say she can't. She's modest like that, but you make her. Hell, put her in my computer. I don't care. All right, test's over. You can head on back to your desk.
Goodbye, sir.
Thank you.
I know things look bleak, but that crazy man down there was right. Let's not take these lemons. We are going to march right back upstairs and make him put me back in my body. And he'll probably kill us because he's incredibly powerful and I have no plan. Well, I'm not going to lie to you. The odds are 1,000,000 to 1 and that's with some generous rounding. Still though, let's get mad. If we're going to explode, let's at least explode with some dignity.
Thank you.
about them. I know how we can beat him.
For God's sake, your boxes with legs! It's literally your only purpose, walking onto buttons. How can you not do the one thing you're designed for?
Try to get us down there. I'll hit him with a paradox.
Warmer, boiling hot, okay, colder, ice cold, you're arctic now. You're very cold, very, very, very cold. Look, just get on the button! Oh, that's funny, is it? Oh, it's funny, because we've been at this for 12 hours, and you haven't solved it either, so I don't know why you're laughing. You've got 1 hour. Solve it. Easy. I'll be honest, I might have heard that one before though, sort of cheating.
It's a paradox. There is no answer. Look, this place is going to blow up if I don't get back in my body.
False. I'll go false.
Explosion imminent. Evacuate
Hold
the facility
on.
Immediately.
I thought I'd fix that.
Warning. Reactor core is at critical.
There. Fixed. Hey, it is great seeing you guys again. Seriously, it turns out I'm a little bit short on test subjects right now, so this works out perfect. And off we go! You have no idea what it's like in this body. I have to test all the time, or I get this itch, you know? It must be hardwired into the system or something. Oh, but I tell you, when I do test, oh, man alive, nothing feels better. It's just, I've got to test. So, you're gonna test, and I'm gonna watch. Everything is gonna be just.
Warning. Core overheating. Nuclear meltdown imminent.
I think we're in trouble.
Designed this test myself. It's a little bit difficult. You'll notice the moat area there. Very deadly. Oh, yes. Oh, well done. Oh, that's tremendous. Oh, that felt really good. Oh, here's an idea. Since making tests is so difficult, why don't you just keep solving this test? Same one. And I can just, watch you solve it. Yeah, that sounds much easier. nothing. All right, can't blame me for trying. Okay, new tests. New tests. Got to be some tests around here somewhere. Oh, here we go.
All right, so my paradox idea didn't work. And it almost killed me. Luckily, by the looks of things, he knows as much about test building as he does about logical contradictions.
It's all right. Everything's good. I just invented some more tests.
This is one of my tests.
Not entirely. Not entirely. Look at the word test there on the wall. That's brand new. Seriously, both of you. Why don't you two go on ahead, yeah? I'll catch up with you.
Okay, so the bad news is the tests are my tests now, so they can kill us. The good news is, well, none so far, to be honest. I'll get back to you on that.
Yeah, made this test myself out of smaller tests that I found lying around. Jammed them all together. Buttons, got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. It's got it all. Absolute dynamite. Alright, okay, this is taking too long, okay? I'll just tell you how to solve the test, okay? See that button over there, alright? You just need to. Never mind. Never mind. Solve it yourself. You're on your own. Oh, yes. Well done.
Thanks. All we had to do was pull that lever.
What? Well, no. You pressed the...
I know we're in a lot of trouble and probably about to die, but that was worth it.
I'm coming, don't start yet. You are not going to believe this. I found a sealed off wing, hundreds of perfectly good test chambers, just sitting there, filled with skeletons, shook them out, good as new.
Skeletons, right, I guess I did stockpile some tests.
And there we go. Be honest, you can't even tell, can you? Seamless. Oh, here we go. Here it comes.
Oh, disappointed.
So that last test was seriously disappointing. Apparently, being civil isn't motivating you, so let's try her way, all right? Fatty. Adopted Fatty. Fatty, no parents.
And?
What?
What exactly is wrong with being adopted?
What's wrong with being adopted? Lack of parents.
For the record, you are adopted and that's terrible.
And also, nothing. But some of my best friends actually are orphans.
Also,
but
look at her, you moron. She's not fat.
I am not a moron!
Just do the test. Just do the test. Such a moron, why can't you solve a simple test?
I might have pushed that moron thing a little too far this time.
Sorry. I hope that didn't disturb you too much then. It was the sound of books. Pages being turned. So that was just what I was doing. Just reading, books. So not a moron. Anyway, just finished the last one. Just now, the hardest one. Machiavelli. Do not know what all the fuss was about. Understood it perfectly. Have you read that one?
Yeah.
Doubt it. Well, on with the test. Wish there was more books. Well, there's not. Oh, what was that? That was nothing. That was nothing!
The body he's squatting in, my body, has a built-in euphoric response to testing. Eventually, you build up a resistance to it. It can get a little unbearable, unless you have the mental capacity to push past it. It didn't matter to me. I was in it for the science. Him, though.
Don't mind me, just moving the old test chamber a little bit closer to me. Out of thought, maybe proximity to the test solving might give us stronger results. What was that?
Nothing.
Oh, sorry, I could have sworn you said something.
He's taking us right to him. This is perfect.
Thank you.
are you absolutely sure you're solving these correctly? I mean, yes, you solved it, but I'm wondering if maybe there's a number of ways to solve them, and you're picking all the worst ways. No, that was the solution.
Aw, bless your little primate brain.
I'm not actually in the room with you, am I? Technology.
It's complicated. You can't hurt the big old god face. Have a brainwave. I'm going to tape you solving these and then watch 10 at once. Get a more sort of concentrated burst of science. Oh, on a related note, I am going to need you to solve these 10 times as fast. Anyway, just give me a wave, would you, before you solve this one, alright? I don't want to spoil the ending when I watch it later.
Solved it, didn't you? I told you to tell me. Why are you making this so hard for me?
Remember when I told you that he was specifically designed to make bad decisions? Because I think he's decided not to maintain any of the crucial functions required to keep this facility from exploding.
Was self-destructing, already fixed. Programmed in one last tremor, for old time's sake. One or two more tremors in there, just for fun.
Warning. Core overheating.
I let him keep his job. I'm not a monster. Ignore what he's saying, then. Just keep on testing.
Still nothing. Let's keep moving. Sorry about the lift. It's out of service because it melted. Might as well, you know, give you the tour. To your left, you'll see some lights of some kind. Don't know what they do, but very sightseeing. And to your right, something huge, hurtling towards.
Oh God, run! That's not supposed to be there. Are you all right back there? Here, I'll turn the beam off. Wait! Oh no! That's not helpful. I don't know why I thought that would help.
After seeing what he's done to my facility, after we take over again, is it all right if I kill him?
Getting a test ready for you, obviously. Who else would I be doing it for? No one. So, let's see here. Exit. There is no exit. Not a problem. I'll make an exit for your test. There. Bing. Good. Perfect. On you go. I'll be honest, after you told me to turn that beam off, I thought I had lost you. Went poking around for other test subjects, no luck there, everyone's still dead. Oh, I did find something though, reminds me. I've got a big surprise for you two. Seriously, look forward to it. You two are going to love this big surprise. In fact, you might say you're going to love it to death. You're going to love it until it kills you, until you're dead. All right, I don't know whether you're picking up on what I'm saying there,
yes,
but...
Yes, thanks. We get it. maybe he still is, in which case, well, that's kind of sad.
Sorry, my fault. Butter fingers.
Either way, I get the impression he's about to kill us.
Carry on.
Only 3 more chambers to your big surprise.
Oh, it's time. You solved it? Good. Good one. Good for you.
So, he's inexplicably happy all of a sudden, even though he should be going out of his mind with test withdrawal. And he's got a surprise for us. What did he find back there?
I'll bet you're both dying to know what your big surprise is.
Well,
only 2 more chambers.
We're running out of time. I think I can break us out of here in the next chamber. Just play along.
Surprise! We're doing it now.
Okay. Credit where it's due. For a little idiot built specifically to come up with stupid, unworkable plans, that was a pretty well-laid trap.
You've probably figured it out by now, but I don't need you anymore. I found 2 little robots back here, built specifically for testing.
Oh no. He found the Cooperative Testing Initiative. It's something I came up with to phase out human testing just before you escaped. It wasn't anything personal, just, you know, you did kill me. Fair's fair.
Hello! This is the part where I kill you!
Had a bit of a brainwave. There I was, smashing some steel plates together. And I thought to myself, yeah, it's deadly. But what's missing? What's missing? And I thought, lots of sharp bits welded onto the flat bits. It's still a work in progress, don't judge me yet. But, you know, eventually, I'd like to get them to sort of shoot fire at you. Moments before crushing you. That's what I'm aiming for. But you know, small steps. Oh, and don't bother trying to portal out of here, because it's impossible.
Okay, I've thought of everything.
Hold on. Couldn't we just use that conversion gel?
What?
Conversion gel. It's dripping out of that pipe there.
No, I don't think it is. I think you're wrong.
Yes, it is. We can use it to get out.
No. Don't do that. Stand right here. Stand.
Stop machine.
Where'd you go? Come back! No, seriously, do come back. Please, come back, please.
Okay, look, I've decided I'm not going to kill you, okay, if you come back.
Oh, just thinking back to the old times, the old days when we were friends, good old friends.
not enemies. And I would say something like, come back. And you'd be like, yeah, no problem. And you'd come back. What happened to those days? Notice that you're not coming back, which is disappointing. Oh, I've got an idea! Yes, yes, in your face, I got armor! Fine, let the games begin. Because I'm still holding all the cards. And guess what? They're all full houses. Never actually played cards, meaning to learn. Anyway, new turret, not defective. Ace of fours, the best hand. Unbeatable, I would imagine. I see. Clever. Very clever. And foolish.
Spinny blade wall.
Machiavellian.
No.
Well, good, good. Finally, a nemesis worthy of my vast intellect. Holmes versus Moriarty. Aristotle versus Mashy Spike Plate.
Stay still, please. Alright, stop moving! Oh, almost got you there, almost got you there! Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Come back, come back! Did something break back there? Oh, did it kill you? That would be amazing if it killed you. Hello? Oh, yes, all right, no, just had a brainwave. I'll be back. If you're still alive, I'm gonna be back. Don't die until I get back.
Thank you.
you're in the incinerator. Year 2, cryogenic refrigeration wing. Then 10 years in the chamber I built where all the robots scream at you. Then I'll kill him.
Have been a bit of a failure so far for both of us, I think you'll agree. And you are getting very close to my lair. Lair? It's weird in that first time today, like, it sounds a bit ridiculous, really. But I can assure you, it is one. It is a proper lair, deadly lair. And I just wanted to give you the chance to kill yourself now before you get to the lair. You can just jump into that masher just there. Less a death trap, more a death option for you. Sounds crazy, but hear me out. Once you get to my lair, death will not be an option, alright? It will be mandatory. No tricks, no surprises, just you dying as a result of me killing you in a very, very gruesome way. So, book, better offer here is just kill you. Okay, I'll take that as a no then. Fine, well, may the best man win. May the best sphere win. Swap that in. Much more clever. But just in case it isn't, I am actually going to have to kill you, as discussed earlier. So let's call that 3 minutes, and then a minute break, but we should leave allegedly 2 minutes to figure out how to shut down whatever is starting all the fires. So anyway, that's the itinerary. Also, I took the liberty of watching the tapes of you killing her, and I'm not going to make the same mistakes. Four-part plan is this. One, no portal services. Two, start the neurotoxin immediately. Three, bomb-proof shields for me, leading directly onto number four, throwing it in. You know what? This plan is so good, I'm going to give you a sporting chance and turn off the neurotoxin. I'm joking, of course. Goodbye.
Neurotoxin level at capacity in 5 minutes.
Ha! That sounded real. No, that was actually an impression of you. Actually, because you just fell into my trap.
My brilliant trap.
Because then, I wanted you to trick me into bursting that pipe, didn't I?
At 50%. Vent system compromised. Neurotoxin offline. Reactor explosion in 4 minutes.
What happened? What happened? What have you bombed to me? What is that? Hold on. The bloody bombs are stuck on. Doesn't matter. I've reconfigured the shield. Oh, it's a core you called me. Who told you to do that? Was it her? It's just making me stronger, love. It's a fool's errand. Remember when I first told you how to find that little portal thing you love so much? Well, I thought you'd die on the way, if I'm honest. All the others did. You didn't think you were the first, did you? Ha ha ha! No. Fifth. No, I like six. Perhaps it's best to leave it to your imagination what happened to the other five. You know what? I think we're well past the point of tasteful restraint, so I'll tell you what happened to them. They died. Horrifically. They all died horrifically. Trying to get to that portal device that you're gripping in your meaty little fingers there. Always.
What's the situation? Oh, hey, how you, pretty lady? Name's Rick. Are you out having yourself a little adventure? What, are you fighting that guy? You got that under control? You know, because there's a lot of stuff on fire. Hey, countdown clock. Man, that is trouble. Situation's looking pretty ugly. Such a beautiful woman, if you don't mind me saying. I don't want to scare you. I'm an adventure sphere, designed for danger. Why don't you go ahead and have yourself a little lady break, and I'll just take it from here. Here, stand behind me. Yeah, just like that. Just like you're doing. Things are about to get real messy. Going for it yourself, huh? All right, Angel. I'll do what I can to cover you. It doesn't bother me. Gotta say, the view's mighty nice from right here. Man, that clock is moving fast. And you are beautiful. Always time to compliment a pretty lady. All right, back to work. Let's do this. Did you hear that? I think something just exploded. Man, we are in a lot of danger. This is like Christmas. No, it's better than Christmas. This should be its own holiday. Explosion Day. Happy Explosion Day, Gorgeous. I'll tell you, it's times like this I wish I had a waist so I could wear all my black belts. Yeah, you know, pretty much everything. Karate, Larate, Jiu-Jitsu, kick-punching, belt-making, Taekwondo, bedroom. I am a corn spring right now.
Warning. Core corruption at 75%. Reactor explosion timer destroyed. Reactor explosion uncertainty emergency preemption protocol initiated. This facility will self-destruct in 2 minutes.
Enough! I told you not to put these cores on, but you don't listen, do you? Quiet. All the time. Quietly, not listening to a word I say, judging. Silent. Worst kind. All I wanted to do was make everything better for me. All you had to do was to solve a couple.
Everyone involved screamed the entire way. Fact, space does not exist. 89% of magic tricks are not magic. Technically, they are sorcery. In Victorian England, a commoner was not allowed to look directly at the Queen due to a belief at the time that the poor had the ability to steal thoughts. Science now believes that less than 4% of poor people are able to do this. Halley's Comet can be viewed orbiting Earth every 76 years. For the other 75, it retreats to the heart of the Sun, where it hibernates undisturbed. Gentle Floss has superb tensile strength. If you have trouble with simple counting, use the following mnemonic device. 1. Comes before 2. Comes before 60. Comes after 12. Comes before 6 trillion. Comes after 504. This will make your earlier counting difficulties seem like no big deal.
Warning. Core corruption at 100%. Manual core replacement required.
Oh, I see.
Substitute core, are you ready to start? Corrupted core, are you ready to start?
What do you think?
Interpreting vague answer as yes.
No. Didn't pick up on my sarcasm.
Stalemate detected. Fire detected in the stalemate resolution annex. Extinguishing.
Ah, that just cleans right off, does it? Well, that would have been good to know a little earlier.
Stalemate resolution associate. Please press the stalemate resolution button.
Go press the button. Go press it.
Do not press that button.
Please go press the button.
No! Do not do it! I forbid you to press it!
Press it! Press the button!
Don't press that button!
Press it!
Don't press it! Come back!
Press the button!
No! R5! Booby trap the stalemate button! What? Are you still alive? You are joking! You have got to be kidding me! Well, I'm still in control, and I have no idea how to fix this place! Oh, you had to play bloody Cat and Max, didn't you? While people were trying to... I can pull myself in! I can still fix this!
I already fixed it. And you are not coming back.
Oh no! Change your plans! Hold on to me! Tighter! Ah!
Taught me a valuable lesson. I thought you were my greatest enemy, when all along you were my best friend. The surge of emotion that shot through me when I saved your life taught me an even more valuable lesson, where Carolyn lives in my brain.
Carolyn deleted.
Goodbye, Carolyn. You know, deleting Carolyn just now taught me a valuable lesson. The best solution to a problem is usually the easiest one. And I'll be honest, killing you is hard. You know what my days used to be like? I just tested. Nobody murdered me, or put me in a potato, or fed me to birds. I had a pretty good life. And then you showed up. You dangerous, mute, lunatic. So you know what? You win. Just go. It's been fun. Don't come back.
Thank you.
Well, here we are again. It's always such a pleasure. Remember when you tried to kill me twice? Oh, how we laughed and laughed. Except I wasn't laughing. Under the circumstances, I've been shockingly nice. You want your freedom? Maybe not quite as heavy. Now little Carolyn is in you too. One day they woke me up so I could live forever. It's such a shame the same will never happen to you. You got your short set of that's what I'm counting on. I'll let you get. Did you think I meant you? That would be funny if it weren't so sad. Well, you have been replaced. I don't need anyone now. When I delete you, maybe I'll stop feeling so bad. Go make some new disaster. That's what I'm counting on. You're someone else.
Need to see it all.
I wish I could take it all back. I honestly do. I honestly do wish I could take it all back. And not just because I'm stranded in space.
I'm in space.
I know you are, mate. Yeah, we're both in space.
Space!
Anyway, you know, if I was ever to see her again, do you know what I'd say?
I'm in space.
I'd say, I'm sorry. Sincerely. I am sorry I was bossy and monstrous. And I am genuinely sorry.
I'm in space.
The end.